Magandang umaga mga kapamilya. Today is the fifth day of the Misa de Gallo. Our Mass presider is Reverend Father Tito Kalua.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God our Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we come to the midway of our Simbang Gabi Masses Novena, today is also known as the Golden Mass, or the Misa Aurea. It's a very ancient, well, Middle Ages tradition, no, that today, people really celebrate this particular Mass with great enthusiasm, you know, and dawn Masses also, where people go to the church with lanterns, praying to our Blessed Mother, asking for her intercession. There's a very long story about this tradition, but we continue the tradition, especially celebrating, you know, the golden moment of our salvation, when Christ is incarnated in the womb of the Blessed Mother. My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. O God, by consenting to the message of an angel, the Immaculate Virgin became the dwelling of your eternal Word and was filled with the light of the Holy Spirit. Give us the grace to follow her example and devote ourselves humbly to your will. We ask this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord spoke to Ahaz, "Ask for a sign from the Lord, your God. Let it be deep as the nether world or high as the sky." But Ahaz answered, "I will not ask. I will not tempt the Lord." Then Isaiah said, "Listen, O house of David. It is not enough for you to weary men, must you also weary my God. Therefore, the Lord himself will give you this sign. The virgin shall conceive and bear a son and shall name him Emmanuel." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory.
Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory.
The Lord's are the earth and its fullness, the world and those who dwell in it. For he founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers.
Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory.
Who can ascend the mountain of the Lord? Or who may stand in his holy place? He whose hands are sinless, whose heart is clean, who desires not what is vain.
Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory.
He shall receive a blessing from the Lord, a reward from God his Savior. Such is the race that seeks for him, that seeks the face of the God of Jacob.
Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, today we complete our three reflections on the three personas or the three persons in the story of the Simbang Gabi. No? So last Monday, we reflected on the story of Joseph. No? And we said it was a testimony of faith. No? And then yesterday, we reflected on the story of Zechariah and also partly Elizabeth. And we said it was a testimony of hope. And today, we reflect on the Blessed Mother's witness, her testimony. And this is now a testimony of love. When you take a look at the gospel, no, and the greeting of the angel, so that is the first point that I invite you to reflect on. "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." So it's the first point of her testimony of love. And then the second point is that you realize now, no, that Mary now would respond to this message of the angel, no, by giving her yes. No? So that is the testimony of love, the testimony of commitment. No? Then finally, this testimony of love we will see in her constancy, no, and fidelity. That's a third point that we will reflect on. So first, about Mary as full of grace. No? You realize that, no, that the Blessed Mother, the being greeted by the angel this way, was a person filled with love. No? Presumably, she was a very prayerful person, And she was living her life, no, in prayer, in always seeking God's will. No? And I think the greeting of the angel really praising her, no, as blessed among women, no, that is a proof of her testimony of living a life of total devotion and love for God. Devotion to God and love for God. So here is the first point that I invite you to reflect on. No? To ask ourselves, no, do we live that our lives that way? No? You know, in a sense, no, I always say that God does not demand perfection. But I think our testimony of witnessing to love is our desire to follow God, our desire to love God through our deeds, no, no matter how imperfect we are. The second point that I invite you to reflect on is Mary's commitment. No? At the end of the day, you know, this is the greatest commitment that we can read in scriptures. I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be done to me according to your word. And for me, the total offering of self is that really, in a sense, that's why the Blessed Mother has the title, you are the highest honor of our human race, because she has given a perfect commitment to God's will and mission for her. Let it be done to me according to your word. I am God's handmaid. I am God's servant. So that is in the end, the perfection of our love is in the perfection of our commitment. How totally we give ourselves to God's mission for us. And most certainly our Blessed Mother is a model, a prototype, the epitome of this commitment in love, loving obedience, second only to our Lord. And then the third and final point of her testimony of love is the fidelity and constancy of living out this commitment. I am the handmaid of the Lord, let it be done to me according to your word. And one of the things that I want you to reflect on is that there were many moments in the life of our Blessed Mother wherein she did not fully understand what was going on. Even in the gospel for today, she asked the angel, how can this be since I do not know man? No? As many scripture scholars and spiritual writers would say, that was a questioning within faith. No? She wanted to understand. So you realize that from the very beginning, discernment. What allowed her to be faithful, to be constant in her commitment, was her constant discernment. And you see that in Scripture. Every time something happens, she does not understand. The birth of our Lord, the presentation in the temple, always you see that line. And she kept all these things in her heart. That was the witness of fidelity and constancy out of love. She kept all these things in her heart. She was going to understand what was difficult to understand in the love that was very deeply planted in her heart. Siguro ngayong araw, pag nilayan natin, no, ang ehemplo ng mahal na birhen, ang kanyang pagiging saksi ng isang pag-ibig, no, na wagas para sa ating Diyos, para sa kagustuhan ng Panginoon. Makikita natin to, di ba, sa pagbati pa lamang ng anghel. Sabi niya, pinagpala ka sa babaeng lahat. Diba? At yun ang ano, the hail full of grace. No? Sumasa iyo ang Panginoon. No? Kaya yun ang unang-una na masasabi natin na ang mahal na birhen ay puspos ng pag-ibig sapagkat siya ay patuloy na nanalangin, lagi niyang hinahanap ang kagustuhan ng Diyos. At yung pangalawang punto ng kanyang pagsaksi, no, sa kanyang pag-ibig ay ang pagtatalaga ng kanyang sarili. Nung naging malinaw sa kanya ang mission niya, anong sabi niya? Ako ang alipin ng Panginoon. Maganap mangyayari sa akin ang iyong sinasabi. Maganap nawa sa akin ang iyong winiwika. Yung kanyang pagmamahal na tulad ng mapagmahal na pagtalima ng Panginoon, ganoon din ang mapagmahal na pagtalima ng mahal na birhen. Siguro maganda tanungin natin ang ating mga sarili, tayo ba ay nabubuhay ng ganyan? Tayo ba ay patuloy na sinasagawa ang gusto ng Diyos na ating misyon? At ito rin yung pangatlong punto, no, ng pagmamahal ng mahal na birhen. ang kanyang tapat at patuloy na pagsasabuhay ng kanyang misyon. Bagaman hindi niya maintindihan lahat ng nangyayari, anong lagi nating nababasa sa banal na kasulatan. At ito'y tinago niya sa kanyang puso at pinagnilayan niya ito sa kanyang puso. Today, let us pray that we may witness to the love that we have for the Lord. Witness in our commitments, that all our commitments will be loving commitments for the Lord, and that we may grow in living a life of prayer and love, and to always be faithful and constant in our loving obedience. Let us pray to the Father that we may be able to follow the example of Mary, who is humble, full of faith, and always ready to do the Lord's will. Full of confidence, we pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May Pope Francis, bishops, priests, and deacons guide and assist us in witnessing to our faith in Christ by inspiring words and exemplary lives, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May those who work in government see their office as a public trust, and may their decisions be for the peace and well-being of our people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Like Mary, may young people be firm in their faith, generous in their love, and steadfast in their hope, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, your eternal word took flesh on earth when the Virgin Mary placed her life at the service of your plan. May we follow your example in preparing for the coming of Jesus, your Son and our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look with favor, Lord, upon the one sacrifice of Christ, that by sharing in this mystery, we may receive the blessings which we long for in faith and in hope. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother long for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord God, defend with your divine power those whom you nourish with heavenly gifts, so that blessed by this sacrament, we may rejoice in the peace which you alone can give through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the Almighty and merciful God, by whose grace we have placed our faith in the first coming of His only begotten Son and yearn for His coming again, sanctify us by the radiance of Christ's advent and enrich us with His blessing.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon us and remain with us forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our life.
Thanks be to God.
Marami pong salamat and have a good day ahead. Thank you.
Spirit soars.